Okay. Welcome back to the session. So, last session we have seen about the different types of analyzers. Okay. We have seen time of flight mass spectrometer, single focusing mass spectrometer, and double focusing mass spectrometer. Okay. So, this class we are going to concentrate on a very interesting one, quadrupole mass spectrometer. Quadrupole mass spectrometer. So this is the spectrometer that was employed in space studies, the Mangalyaan I told, and the Mars rover. Okay, any of the space studies, this particular mass spectrometer is used. So we are going to see the working of this quadrupole mass spectrometer. First, we'll justify the name. Okay, so see the name. It is quadrupole. It is quadrupole. You can just separate into two parts. Quadrupole. So essentially, it contains of four poles. Essentially, it contains four poles. Okay, so four poles. You are going to apply two things. One is a DC signal. Okay, four poles. So one is going to have a positive DC signal, that is two poles are going to have positive DC, and another two poles are going to have negative DC. Along with this, we are going to add, okay, we are going to add RF audio, RF signal, okay, and RF AC signal. It's an AC signal. You're going to add a DC and a AC signal. Okay, so literally this looks like, say we have two poles which has a DC current as well as RF. So say this is positive DC and RF. This also positive DC and RF. We have another two poles, okay, that's why the name it is. So these two are in different plane actually. Can you visualize? So say these two are in this direction, the plus DC and RF, and these two are in this direction. So here it will be minus DC and RF. Here also it is minus DC and RF. Okay, so what we are trying to achieve is four poles. So one is in one plane and second one is in another plane. Say this positive will be like this, the second will be like this. So we are essentially trying, we can just visualize this way also. Okay, two poles over here. Say this is positive with AC. These two poles are here, these are minus with AC. Okay, these are all positive with AC, these are all minus with AC. Now what is the purpose of this arrangement? Actually, we want to differentiate between different ions, different ping pong balls, and you have different snooker balls. We want to differentiate them. So when these actually we have this arrangement, it's quadrupole, and just put it like this. Okay, so what happens when these ions travel through this four poles? When it travels, these four acts like a filter. This four combination acts like a filter, thereby a specific mass to charge ratio, a specific mass to charge ratio comes out of the four poles, which will be given to the detector. Okay, a specific thing comes out of it, that will be detected by your detector. Okay, now how this works, we'll see it. The basic idea is this one. This four is going to act as a filter, whereby a specific mass to charge will flow through it. All the others will hit the plates. all the others will hit the plates, only a specific will go to the come outside. Okay, you remember in our double focusing and single focusing, only is by in single focusing, by varying the magnetic field, only a specific mass to charge was directed outside. In a similar manner, by these four poles, we are trying to create a kind of filter which will specific mass to charge will be sent out, all others will be deflected. Okay, so it acts as a filter kind of thing. To be more specific, we want to create a band pass filter, a band pass filter which is going to specific only here band pass in terms of mass to charge. Okay, that particular mass to charge alone will be allowed to pass, all others will be getting deflected. We'll see how this will work. Okay, this actually works on two fundamental principles. This entire concept works on two fundamental principles. Okay, so the principles are like this. They're quite basic fundamental principles that we have already studied. One is that we know that like charges ripple, unlike charges attract. Unlike charges attract. This is the basic phenomenon we all know. Okay, basic electrostatic repulsion attraction. Like charge ripple, unlike charge attract. What is the second rule? Second rule is heavier ions take more time to drift than smaller ions. Take more time to drift than smaller ions. That is, larger ions will take more time to drift for maneuvering. Okay, so heavier will take more time to drift rather than smaller ions. Okay, these are the two fundamental principles that is helpful for us to understand this phenomenon of quadrupole mass spectrometer. One is like charge ripple, unlike charge attract, basic one. Second one, heavier ion take more time to drift compared to smaller ions. Okay, how this is both you're going to will see it. Okay, so for our purpose, we are going to use we're going to classify two ions. One is a smaller mass ion and another one is a bigger mass ion. We are going to just classify this by using our quadrupole filter. Quadrupole filter, we are going to separate this. Okay, to separate this, you can just visualize your smaller ion to be like a speedboat. Visualize this to be a speedboat and this bigger one to be a Titanic boat. You can just visualize. Okay, Titanic ship, you cannot call it as a boat, it's a Titanic ship, right? So this will be a smaller speedboat. Okay, what is the nature of this speedboat? Why it's called speedboat? It can go very fast. It can go very fast. Whereas Titanic boat, Titanic ship, it will be very big, no? So it will take more time. Slowly it will change. It cannot change very fast. Whereas your speedboat, it can change very fast. So smaller ions can change very fast. Your bigger ions take more time to change. Take more time to change. Okay, so we are going to use the bigger ions, we are going to visualize as a Titanic boat. Smaller ions we are going to visualize as a speedboat. Okay, okay, now what we are going to do is that we can visualize how this filter is working. Okay, so for that purpose, I am just taking up first only the two poles. Okay, I am taking only the first two poles. I'm taking first two poles alone. Okay, I'm going to apply a positive DC on these plates. I'm going to apply a positive DC on these plates. Okay, I'm going to use a DC current, okay, a DC current, a positive DC current on this one. So by varying the current, I'll be able to vary the potential, okay. So I'm supplying a DC, okay, this is a DC, okay. Now imagine you have only the DC. Imagine you have only the DC, okay. Now I'll consider two ions. One is the smaller speed boat and the second one is the larger Titanic boat, okay. Both are positive ions. See, both are positive ions. This is also positive, okay. What will happen now? Since this is positive and this is also positive, what is the underlying mechanism? Unlike poles or like poles ripple, like poles ripple, right? Okay, so the basic motion for these two is in this direction only, okay, because it will not be getting attracted at all. Okay, so the basic motion for both the ions are, because this is also positive, this is also positive, this is also positive, this is also positive, so its basic motion will be traveling outside. Maybe it will take different times to come according to the mass, but both will come out at after a particular time, say t, both these ions will come out, will not be able to differentiate. Now to differentiate it, okay, to differentiate it, what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply AC. I'm going to apply an RF signal AC, okay. So what is the AC? It will go for a positive and it will go for a negative. It will have a positive as well as a negative, and again go for a positive, negative, okay. It will change automatically. Now we'll take the Titanic boat. What happens? So Titanic boat, what is the natural motion? Since this is positive, this is also positive, the natural motion is along this way only, okay. So first the boat starts, it starts to travel. So DC is positive, AC is also positive, it is in positive off cycle, this is positive, so it is trying to travel in this fashion. Once it moves to the negative off cycle, as positive off cycle it's okay. Once it goes to the negative off cycle, and when the potential value magnitude is larger than this DC, when it is larger than this DC, what will happen? The net potential will become negative. Once this becomes negative, this is positive, what it will do? It will try to move towards negative. It will come because it will take very slow time to change. It's a very big mass, no, Titanic boat. Then by the time it almost goes towards it, the next half cycle will come, you'll get positive, okay, positive. So now it will change positive again. By the time it next cycle comes, it negative again, it will go positive, negative, and it finally comes out, okay. So now the big mass ion came out, okay. It will take more time to change, whereas you take the speedboat, initially both are positive, so it was moving like this. So next negative, it can change very fast, negative, next positive, next negative. What will happen? It will impact, okay. See, the Titanic boat, since because the natural path is in this way, so once it becomes negative, it changes. Once again it becomes positive, it goes away. Again it goes negative, near, positive, near. So because it takes more time to change, this comes out large. But this one gets, so this DC positive as well as AC will act like a high mass filter. I mass filter. Okay, if you are something, if you put like this all the mass to charge, so this will act like a, so it will block this particular region. I'll take an eraser. Okay, so it will pass only I mass alone. Okay, it will alone only pass this particular mass, AV masses. Okay, so this particular combination of positive DC and RF, that is AC, acts like a I mass filter. It will allow only the I mass to flow through. Okay, now we'll see the case of a negative. Okay, I'll just take again, I'm going to use this time negative plates. I'm going to use the other two plates which are supplied with negative potential. Okay, so I am supplied with negative, both these plates are negative, so I'm applying a DC of negative potential. Okay, so this is DC, I have applied negative. Okay, this is applied negative. Now we'll visualize what will happen for both the ions. First we have a smaller ion, then we have a bigger ion. This is our speed boat, this is our Titanic boat. Okay, we'll see what happens. Okay, see, by virtue of its, this is negative, this is also negative, these two are positive. What will be the most preferred path? The most preferred path is this will go and strike here, this will go and strike here, because it will try to, it will be getting attracted towards the opposite plate. So opposite charges attract, like charges repel. In this case opposite charge, so it will get attracted. Okay, now we don't want, because nothing will come out of this output, but we don't want this scenario. So I'm just removing this part. Okay, so now we'll see what we'll do to prevent this particular thing. We are going to add a AC. I'm going to add a AC to both. Okay, now we have AC. Now we'll see what happens. This is negative, so your AC will have positive as well as negative. Your AC will have positive. So we'll take first the Titanic thing. So what is the preferred path actually? Preferred path is in this direction only, because this is negative. It will move towards this only. Okay, this is a preferred path. In the previous case, the preferred path was in the center, because both are positive. It wishes to travel only in the center, whereas here the preferred path is towards a negative plate, so it will travel toward this part. Okay, the preferred path. Now when it is a negative half cycle, both are negative, so it will be in this motion only. But for positive half cycle, when this magnitude crosses your DC, okay, magnitude is, when it becomes positive, what will happen? When it becomes positive, it will try to move away. But this is a Titanic boat, no? It will take more time to drift. It will take more time to drift. Again, next cycle, negative will come. Next negative, positive, negative. See? Okay, because the preferred path is in this direction. First, say positive comes, it moves away. So the net potential is positive, so it moves away. Again, for the next half cycle, it becomes negative, it moves towards. Again, it becomes positive, it moves away. At one point of time, it will get striked. Okay, now take the case of a speedboat. Okay, speedboat is very fast. Okay, so its preferred path is towards here, it becomes positive, it becomes negative, positive, negative, positive. Okay, and finally it comes out. Okay, it will change fast, so it comes out. So now we have our smaller MOS ion coming out. So we can tell this particular combination acts as a low mass filter. This acts as a low mass filter. Okay, so the combination of negative DC and the combination of negative DC and your AC, that is RF, acts like a low mass filter. What is low mass? You can just put it like this. So it will only allow lower masses to pass through. The higher masses will be truncated. Okay, so now we saw with plus DC and AC it acted like an high mass filter. With minus DC and AC it acts like a low mass filter. So put together both the things. Okay, put together both the things. So this will essentially act like a, so suppose this is your plus DC and AC. These two are plus DC and AC. These two are minus DC and AC. Okay, we are having all these four tubes. So this will act like a band pass filter. This will act like a band pass filter. Okay, so I think we need to put the reverse of it. Okay, these two will act like a band pass filter. It will permit only a particular band. Okay, combination of this high pass and low pass is a band pass. Okay, it will permit only a particular mass. Okay, so it has a charge, so mass to charge. So it will permit only a particular bond. So if four ions or five ions are coming out, okay, by varying this potential DC and AC potential, by varying this you can make a particular mass to charge ratio to come out. You can base particular mass to charge. So what you have to do is we need to change this window. So what we do is that first keep the window here, we'll keep the window over here by varying this potential. So a particular mass will come out. Okay, so I'll just take, so say something comes out, output. Okay, and again you move this window to here, say nothing comes in, then again you move the window over here. Okay, you observe another peak. Okay, you get a peak, say. So this way you will move this window, you will move this window, and you will be able to separate particular mass to charge ratio elements out. Okay, you will be able to separate particular mass to charge ratio elements out. Okay, so this is how your quadrupole mass spectrometer works. Okay, so by varying this DC and AC, it's going to act like a band pass filter, so that it selectively selects particular ions to pass through your four tubes. So these four tubes form called as quadrupole mass spectrometer. Okay, so again I told you, in all the spectrometers what is going to change is the analyzer part. Okay, here the analyzer is, here the analyzer is quadrupole. In previous case it was single focusing, it was double focusing. Okay, so that's the basic idea of quadrupole mass spectrometer. Okay, so the last part of your mass spectrometer is a detector. The last part is a detector. Okay, so a detector is essentially, it is need to convert these ions into electrons. We need to convert these ions into electrons. Okay, So we'll see only two types of detector. One is a simple ion multiplier. We can use a simple ion multiplier. Second one is we'll see a scintillation counter. Scintillation counter. Okay. So that's how you differentiate between the ions. Okay, which we'll see it in the next class. Thank you.